Hi, I'm Matt from Duo Security. In this video, I'm going to show you how to enable and use the Duo Self-Service Portal. The Duo Self-Service Portal saves time for administrators and end users by eliminating the need to contact IT staff to manage authentication devices. Your users can add, edit, and remove authentication factors using the Duo prompt during the normal login process. The documentation for the self-service portal is located at duo.com/docs/self-service-portal. Please read it before watching this video. The self-service portal feature is part of the Duo Beyond, Duo Access, and Duo MFA plans. The portal is an available option for Duo web-based applications, VPN applications, and Microsoft applications that allow use of inline self-enrollment and use of the Duo prompt. This includes Juniper and Cisco SSL VPNs, WordPress, Microsoft OWA, and Duo Access Gateway. If your application does not show the Duo prompt, you can allow self-service by setting up a standalone device management portal instead. Learn more about this application at duo.com/docs/device-management. To enable the self-service portal, log in to the Duo admin panel as a Duo administrator with the owner, administrator, or application manager role. Click on Applications in the left sidebar. The portal is enabled on a per-application basis. Click on the name of the application you want to enable self-service for. In this video, we are going to enable self-service for our Microsoft OWA application. Scroll down to the Settings section. If the application supports the self-service feature, you will see an option to enable the self-service portal. Click the checkbox to enable the portal. Then click Save Changes. The self-service portal is now accessible after enrolled users complete primary authentication for the application. When accessing an application, users will complete primary authentication as they normally do. Enabling self-service provides users with two additional links in the Duo prompt: Add a new device and My Settings and Devices. They must complete two-factor authentication before being granted access to either of these features. If the user clicks Add a new device, they complete two-factor authentication and then are immediately taken to the device enrollment process. They can follow the prompts to add a new authentication device. In this example, the user is adding a new landline device. After adding the device, the user is taken to My Settings and Devices, where they will see a list of their authentication devices. This is the screen the user would have arrived at if they had clicked My Settings and Devices instead of Add a New Device from the Duo prompt. From the list of devices, the user can click Device Options next to a Devices entry to reactivate Duo Mobile if applicable, change the device's name, or delete it. For example, this user can change the name of their iOS smartphone to Main Cell Phone. Below the list of devices, there is an option to add another authentication device. The process for adding a device through this link is the same as the process shown earlier. Users can also select their default authentication device and whether they would like to receive an automatic push or phone call or manually select an authentication method when they reach the Duo prompt. After the user has finished managing their devices, they can click Continue to Login to return to the initial screen of the Duo prompt, complete two-factor authentication, and access the application. The Duo Security Self-Service Portal helps administrators and end users save time. Enable it on your applications for secure, simple device management.